when niggas ask you about the body count, is because they insecure about they dick. Niggas with good dick ain't gonna ask you nothing like that. Niggas with good dick, they ain't gonna ask you about your body count. You know why? They don't give a fuck. Cause they know they finna stretch that pussy the fuck out. Bitch, I don't give a fuck who you was fucking before. This pussy mine now. They finna numb your dengue cure that pussy. They finna that pussy. So they not finna ask you no questions like, oh, what's your body count? For what? Are you crazy? No, they're not gonna ask you that. It's always the niggas with wormy dick. I'm lying? Am I lying? It's always the niggas with wormy dick.
Yo, she crazy. And I know she playing, but for every joke, there has to be a little bit of truth to it for it to even be funny. So this is probably her truth. But in order for her to form this type of opinion, or for anybody for that matter, your body count has to be high. Because you don't come to this conclusion off of two or three bodies. It has to be a nice sample size of about 20 plus. Now, since your body count is pretty high, you want to try to shame a guy for asking you about it, because now you're embarrassed to tell him. See, a woman with a low body count, she'll damn near volunteer that information to you when the conversation of sex comes up by saying she's not that experienced because she hasn't had that many sex partners. But a woman with a high body count, there's no way she gonna volunteer any information about no body count numbers. But usually a woman's body count is pretty obvious to a man just by his dealings with her. Let's take two 30-year-old women, one with the body count of 20 and the other with the body count of 5. Now, the three-step process of meeting, getting to know, and sleeping with a 30-year-old woman with a body count of 20 is a fast process. You can probably sleep with this woman in about 30 days. Now, the three-step process of meeting, getting to know, and sleeping with a woman, with a 30-year-old woman, with the body count of 5, is a slow process. You probably won't sleep with this woman till about 6 months to a year. But don't get me wrong, there is an exception to every situation, because there's women out here with low body counts that has met a man that was everything that she wanted, and she slept with him in about 30 days or less, and that was out of her norm. But on the flip side, there's women out here with high body counts that has made a man wait about 6 months, and that was out of her norm too. The problem is you got guys out here actually trying to co-sign this video. Let me tell you something, ladies. There's only two reasons a guy is not gonna ask you about your body count. One is because he don't care about the number of guys that have slid in you because he's trying to slide in too. And the second reason is because he's actually taking the time to get to know you, and he's putting two and two together, and he's realized you're not the type of woman that's gonna sleep around. Because any man out here looking for a wife kind of wants to know what his woman's body count is, whether she lies about it or not. Because he's not trying to marry a woman that has slept with 99 dudes, and now he's the foolish one. He wants to know how many guys done threw your pH balance off. He wants to know how many guys you still sexually attached to. Because even though you done stopped having sex with a guy and then blocked his number and all of that, you still sexually attached to a man. There's some science behind it. And some of you educated women that value your box already know what I'm talking about. But y'all tell me how y'all feel in the comments below. Like and subscribe and follow me on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram at QuoteOneself. I'll see y'all next time.